quieres a tu lado. Qué lindo sería si tú me das, te invito a que dejemos todo un lado. Que empieza la liga, yo sé que me dices que sí, que sí, que sí, que sí. Yo sé que me dices que sí.
And we continue talking football here on the Sportsmax Zone. It's when you hear that sound, it means it's time to talk La Liga. Action from round 3 in La Liga got on the way today with 2 games. In the late match, Osasuna traveled to Seville to tackle Real Betis. We have the highlights.
And I Garcia was having none of that. Down by Jimmy Avila, opportunity here, the ball hits the post and the follow-up is blocked inside the 6-yard box, a combination of the goalkeeper and Edgar Gonzalez. It was Jimmy Avila who got things going with a delicately weighted ball to Moy Gomez. And then Peña, again options in the centre, here comes a cross. Sent in at speed. Here comes the second wave of the attack. 4 players in the area, including Jorge Iglesias. Iglesias gets onto his right foot, blasts the ball into goal. Jorge Iglesias strikes again. Osasuna reject the initial cross. Iglesias shows for it. Defensive disarray there as nobody followed Jorge Iglesias out. He had the option to square to Fekir, but he had something else on his mind. He was playing his first minutes of the season. He gets back on the ball here. Jorge Iglesias comes out to show for it. He was acting as a decoy because here comes Fekir. Fekir again! This time goes for goal. Around from Manu Sanchez, just hit that slightly too far. He's taken down. There's going to be a red card for Petzela, a straight red. Moy Gomez is the man who tries to do so. And there was that chaos we were talking about. But Rui Silva remains calm. Effort of delivery, the header over the top from Ante Budimir. Canales to Luis Henrique. Game over at the Benito Villamarín. Real Betis continue their run.
Real Betis winning 1-0 there. And in the day's early match, Girona hosted Celta Vigo. That match ended 1-0 to Celta Vigo. La Liga action continues on the weekend, and these are the fixtures down to be contested. Elche at home to Real Sociedad. Rayo Vallecano play Mallorca. Almeria face Sevilla, Getafe up against Villarreal, Barcelona play Valladolid, Espanyol up against Real Madrid, Cadiz play Athletic Bilbao, and Valencia versus Atletico Madrid. Barcelona are soon expected to complete the registration of Jules Koundé, irrespective of whether Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang stays or leaves for Chelsea. La Liga is pleased with the measures they have taken to fall in line with the financial fair play regulations. George, saw this coming?
Yeah, well, yeah, the space was already made for this to happen. La Liga making it seem as if, you know, well, you know, we are in our good graces now, so yes, we are allowing you to do this. No, you're not allowing the club to do that. The club did the work to fall in line with the rules you created. So it's not the La Liga front office doing Barcelona a favor. Fact is that it was always on the cards that Jules Koundé was going to come on, because he played in all of the unofficial matches that Barcelona have had since his transfer from Sevilla. And he even took the number of the man who he replaced. Now, you spoke about Aubameyang's going or staying not affecting the Koundé transfer or the Koundé registration. And that is true, because there's already room made for him by the fact that Barca have loaned out the Frenchman Samuel Umtiti, another central defender that they had. His old shirt number was worn by Koundé in that match that they played against Manchester City for ALS in midweek. Yeah. And so it was clear to anyone with half a brain that Umtiti would have been the man to make way for Koundé on the Barcelona books. And by virtue of his official loan, he has moved on from the club, that opens the way with the salary cap and how they designed that particular deal for Okwunde to get registration, to get registered, man, for the registration to be done.
Yeah, got it. Well, defending champions Real Madrid are set to lose yet another player. Marco Asensio has informed his manager, Carlo Ancelotti, that he wishes to leave the club and he's now reportedly on Manchester United's radar. Lance, what is up with Manchester United?
Wait, you don't want to ask about Asensio? George, 4 or 5 years ago, Asensio had looked as if he was shaping up to be a very prominent player.
Yes.
Not only as a Spanish international, but a Barca standout.
Well, yes, because himself and Isco at the time.
I remember that.
If you remember, we did some promos here at Sportsmas, and I done one about Asensio and Iñaki Williams from Athletic Bilbao.
Yes.
The fact is, and this is what I'm saying about the Fofana transfer from Leicester to Chelsea. Fofana had this massive injury, and we don't know what we're going to get because after coming back from a serious injury, Marco Asensio hasn't been the same.
Yes.
What is true, though, is that in last season, he scored some vital goals for Real coming off the bench. And that is how Carlo Ancelotti has sought to use him as an impact sub because he does know where the goal is and he has a wonderful left foot. But the engine that he had and the creativity to make his own goal, he hasn't quite shown that, so you use him in spurts. At this stage of his career, the boy has said that, look, he wants to be in a team where he plays week in, week out, and he realizes that the impact sub role is not what he wants. Maybe if he goes to Manchester United, he'd have to play his way into the team. If he's good enough, he'll get a game there. But I think that he's being set up, this transfer is a kind of stalking horse. Man United really want Ajax, really want Anthony from Ajax. So how they set it up is this. You're going to hear these stories about Manchester United being interested in players who play a similar position. Just to say to Ajax, listen,
rush it.
If you engage in brinkmanship and you don't want to take this money that we're offering,
we
have another option that we're lining up. So they'll say, oh, you know what? Let's not push for more money because they have an alternative. So we don't want to lose this money. And they go to the alternative, which will be way cheaper. Yeah. So this is all part of that.
And to be honest, I think Asensio, he's still young. He's 26 years old. I think he has a lot of scope. As George mentioned, coming off an injury, it sort of stuttered his trajectory as an impact player. Because to me, this is a player who has international quality. And I think if he goes to Man United, he could offer Man United a lot. I know, as we have pointed out, that he hasn't really flourished in recent years. But I think he has the talent and the tools to be a very, very outstanding player.
Before his injury, he was a regular in the Spain squad.
That's right.
No, he can't even get invited. If they call up a 30-man squad, he's not likely to get called up.
I just find it so strange that, you know, a lot of the Real Madrid players, they're coming from defending champion team. You know, your team has been doing excellently, but they're moving or they're putting their hands up and, you know, requesting a move. And the move is to Manchester United.
Well, you explain that by this way. Again, players like him, and he has every medal in Spain in his locker, and of course the Champions League, he has multiples.
And still in his mid-20s, that's the point I'm making.
Right,
yeah.
So most players who move, all right, look at the Manchester City players. Mm-hmm. If they leave Man City, they'll be leaving for Champions League opportunities or maybe a bigger salary. But the Real Madrid players, there's no trophy that they're moving to win because they've won everything that most players in world football have never won.
Yes.
So they have satisfied that aspect of them. So it's about taking care of their innate desire to be involved week in, week out in a rotation.
And sometimes, George and Mariah, you have to put yourself, if you can, in these players' shoes. And I think Asensio, within himself, knows his quality and knows his potential and knows what he has done.
Right.
And he wants more opportunities.
Don't forget one thing too.
Yes.
Don't forget one very important thing. November, World Cup.
Cup.
Nobody wants to be sitting on the bench and hoping that the manager gives them some garbage time, a little 10 minutes here, a little 5 minutes here.
Yeah.
They want to be able to play week in, week out, to say to Luis Enrique, the Spanish coach, pick me, I'm in form, I'm playing every week. There you go.
Correct.
That's right.
Yeah. All right, team, let's take a quick break and come back. We have a lot more to talk about. Si tú me dices ahorita que me quieres a tu lado, qué lindo sería.